I want to create a vector brush in Affinity Designer with dots for the background, or any other shape, of course, any stars or whatever, multiple different designs. Of course, it could be anything other than this, but this is, now this is a design I created in an earlier video. Please check that out. What you can do, File and New, and that's a key thing. Make sure it's a transparent background. You can see transparent background. If you create it with white behind it, if you've got just white as the artboard, then unfortunately you end up with a white background to your brushstroke, which is not so great. Well, what you can then do is go to File and Export it. You need to save it. You need to save it as a raster file format. You've got preview there, you can see the brush. I'm gonna go for whole document, 1024 by 600, and I can export. So export, and I'm gonna go with spots 15, and save. So that's saved. Now what I'm gonna do, go to a fresh document, and you can see brushes, the brushes panel. Just go over here to the vector brush, and that's in the tools panel. So tools brush, and you've got the brushes. View, menu, studio and brushes. And apply one of these brushes. Now I'm just gonna go for oil. So I'm just gonna go for this one, very basic one. You can see the design there. And you can change the size. So you decide, you know what? I don't want that at 64, I want that. Go to the move tool, and you can just change it, tweak it, just increase the size, maybe a bit more, so you can see your design. Now I don't want black. There. Weirdly, it says the fill and the stroke are not anything. It's a very odd feature. I've never understood that bit. However, go over here to the gradient tool. So gradient tool, you've got the gradient. Context, it puts it as fill, which is odd because it's a stroke, but it's got fill. You can always set it to stroke. So set it to stroke and then go to here, type, bitmap. Now you can set it to anything else as well, linear. So maybe go for linear, you can see your gradient applied then to that. But I want it bitmap, because that's the PNG file. So bitmap, and then go for spots 15. Now in this case, it doesn't particularly matter with the transparency, but click open there. You can see the design, obviously it's got design there, and you can resize it. You can move it around, you can... Now there is a slight issue with the bits of gaps there. That's a feature that seems to always happen. Not certain why, but you can resize it. Please put in the comments below if you know of a reason why there's gaps there, why it seems to give a little bit of a gutter or margin between that. Just seems odd. But you don't really notice if you've got it very large like that, because it should connect. And if you go to the brush, you just click on there, you can see the design. Looks fine to me. Brush width, you can change that. Click close, and you've got your design there. I can now delete it, because I'm going to do another one now, another brush, but it's going to be one of these ones. How to do that? We'll go to brushes panel, go to the brushes over here, and this is the reason I went for the transparency. Without transparency, you'd end up with a white background, or if you had a blue background, it would end up with blue, solid blue background there. So go to this, and go to new textured image brush. New textured image brush, and you can see ones I've created earlier with the white background, so it's not great. So new texture, and then select that file, and you can see spots 15, click open, and now it's added and it's got no white. So if I go for this one, and I'm just going to select the one that I created with white, which I did in an earlier video, just going to go here to the vector brush, select that, and you can apply it, and you can see now what happens. It gets this white across it. Not ideal. However, you select this one, and this is the one with transparency, you can apply it, and you can see now it goes over. Obviously anything goes over, you don't get that white. Depends if that's what you want. If you want the white, perfectly reasonable to have it. You can see you can create all kinds of brush strokes, and of course you can always resize. So you can say, oh, I want it a bit bigger than that, because it's quite a large file. It's 1024, so you've got a fair amount to work with. It's just a raster size. It's a raster file, so it's not a vector design, unfortunately. And you can apply your brush stroke, and you can see you can fill very quickly your design with your brush stroke. And of course, you can always go back to the, if you've got the source spots and designs, of course, you can always modify them, change the colors, and then create a new brush with that. Hope you found this of interest. Thank you much.